Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to transform an ordinary pumpkin into a glowing Halloween jack-o'-lantern. I provided this image of a pumpkin so you can follow along. Its link is located in the video description or project files. Double-click on the thumbnail of the layer and name it Base. We need to make the photo look like it was shot in the evening or at night, so we'll use adjustment layers. Click on the adjustment layer icon. For this photo, go to Levels and make the input midtone level 0.69 and the white output level 105. Since evening and night shots tend to have a blue color cast, you could use photo filter, but for this example, I'll choose color balance because it allows me to finesse the colors. In midtones, change the cyan red to -28 and the magenta green to -8. Open shadows. Make the cyan red -12 and the yellow blue 8. To bring out more of the orange color in the pumpkins, open your adjustment layer list and choose selective color. In reds, make the cyan -56% and the magenta and yellow +100. As I toggle back and forth, you can see the difference. To save space, let's group all these layers into a folder. With the top layer active, shift-click on the thumbnail of the bottom layer to highlight all the layers. Press Ctrl-G on a PC or Command-G on a Mac. We'll name the folder Base. Click on the New Layer icon to make a new layer. We'll start making the shapes for the eyes, nose, and mouth of the pumpkin. Open your Lasso tool and draw a shape for the left eye. We'll fill it with black, and since black is the foreground color, press Alt-Delete on a PC or Option-Delete on a Mac. Click on the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the active layer. Double-click on the thumbnail of the layer to open its Layer Style window. Click Color Overlay and the Color Box. Type in FA8001, then click OK or press Enter or Return. Click Inner Shadow and the Color Box. Type in A7010D. Change the blend mode to normal and make the opacity 100%. Uncheck global light and make the angle -128°. Keep the distance 5 pixels and make the size 27 pixels. Click outer glow and the color box. Type in the same color as you used just before and change the blend mode to linear dodge. Make the opacity 50% and the size 29 pixels. Click drop shadow and the color box. Pick the same color and change the blend mode to normal. Make the opacity 50%, uncheck global light, and make the angle -45°. Make the distance 3 pixels and the size 7 pixels. Then click OK. Next, we'll show the illumination of the light inside the left eye. Make a new layer. Go to the layer mask and press and hold Alt or Option as you drag a copy of it next to the empty layer. Click on the empty layer to make it active and draw a shape that's similar to the contours of the left eye. Leave a little space on the right side and a much larger space on the left side. Go to Select, Modify, and Feather. Feather the selection 1 pixel. Click on the foreground color and type in FEF131. Fill it with the foreground color and delete the selection. Next, we'll add some texture to the pulp. Make a new layer and drag a copy of the layer mask next to it. Make the empty layer active and open your brush tool. Make the size 45 pixels and the hardness 0%. Change the blend mode to dissolve and the opacity is 100%. Brush across the inside edge of the pulp. To brush over the thin part of the pulp, reduce your brush size by pressing the left bracket key. Now, brush over the inside edge of the thin pulp. We need to blur the texture and reduce its opacity. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 1 pixel and reduce its opacity to 50%. Next, we'll make the right eye. But first, let's place all the layers that comprise the left eye into a folder. We'll name it Left Eye. Make a new layer and draw the shape of the right eye. Make the foreground and background colors default to black and white respectively. To do this, click the small double box icon or press the letter D on your keyboard. Fill it with the foreground color and delete the selection. Open the folder of the left eye, go to Effects, and press and hold Alt or Option as you drag a copy of it to the right eye. Now, both eyes have the same layer styles. Since the right eye has a slightly different perspective than the left eye, we need to make a minor adjustment in the drop shadow. Double-click on Drop Shadow and change its angle to minus 137. Next, we'll add the illumination of light inside the eye. Close the folder and make a new layer. Drag a copy of the layer mask next to the empty layer. Make the empty layer active and draw a shape similar to the contours of the right eye. Leave a wide space on the right side. Go to Select, Modify, and Feather. As before, feather it 1 pixel. Open your Eyedropper tool by pressing Ctrl or Command I. Click down on the yellow to pick up its color. Then, fill the selection with the color and delete the selection. Next, we'll add the texture to the pulp. Make a new layer and drag the layer mask next to the empty layer. Make the empty layer active and press B to open your brush tool. To make the brush larger, press the left bracket key. Now, brush over the inside edge of the pulp. Reduce its opacity to 50% and press Ctrl or Command F to repeat the last filter, which was Gaussian Blur. Group the layers of the right eye into a folder. Name it Right Eye. Make a new layer and press L to open your lasso tool. Draw the shape of the nose. Press D to make the colors default to black and white and fill the selection with black. Make a layer mask of the selection next to the nose. Open the folder of the right eye and drag a copy of its effects to the nose. Close the folder and make a new layer. As before, drag the layer mask next to the empty layer. Make the empty layer active and draw a similar shape of the nose, keeping the space for the pulp not quite as wide as we did for the eyes. Go to Select, Modify, and Feather. Feather it 1 pixel. Open your Eyedropper tool, pick up the yellow color, fill the selection, and delete it. Make a new layer and drag a copy of the layer mask next to it. Make the empty layer active and open your brush tool. Brush over the inside edge of the pulp reduce its opacity to 50%, and blur it. Group the nose layers into a folder and name it Nose. Make a new layer and open your lasso tool. Draw the mouth and make the foreground color black. Fill the selection and make a layer mask. Open the nose folder and drag a copy of the effects to the mouth. Close the folder and make a new layer. As before, drag a copy of the layer mask next to the empty layer and make the empty layer active. Draw the shape of the mouth, leaving space at the bottom and sides. Press and hold Alt or Option as you draw a shape for the side of the top left tooth. Repeat this for the side of the top right tooth. Feather the selection. Open your eyedropper tool, pick up the color, fill the selection, and delete it. Repeat the same procedures as you did earlier to add texture to the pulp. Group the mouth layers into a folder and name it Mouth. Next, we'll make the illumination inside the pumpkin spill out onto the grass in front of the pumpkin. Open the base folder and make the base image active. Make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Drag it above the mouth folder and make a layer mask next to the pumpkin. Invert it by pressing Ctrl or Command I. Make the brush size 150 pixels and change the blend mode to normal. Brush across the grass in front of the pumpkin. This reveals the daytime photo through the layer mask. Since the illumination has a warm glow to it, double-click on the pumpkin thumbnail to open its layer style window. Click Color Overlay and the color box. Type in 3Fs CD0. Change the blend mode to linear burn. You can see the difference as I toggle back and forth. Have fun making your own custom jack-o'-lantern. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.